stinging dental pesto. One of my favorite pesto. So basically, this is a stinging nettle. So if you want a very tasty pesto, you will need to get the very young leaf. So when if you pick up the nettles yourself, just pick the top of the nettles. And then if you buy often, they will sell only the young leaf. So stinging nettles, it means that it's stinging. And to avoid the stinging effect, you need to drop the nettle in lukewarm water and ideally with vinegar. Same thing, when you pick up the nettles and you feel some pain because of the stinging effect, then you can put a little bit of vinegar onto the area, and then all the effects will be removed. But let's go, let's prepare a stinging nettle pesto together.
For this recipe, you need stinging nettles, half a lemon, one garlic clove, hazelnuts, apple cider vinegar, and olive oil. Throw the hazelnuts on the oven tray and place the hazelnuts in the oven under the grill until they get golden. Place the hazelnuts in the colander and with a tea towel just remove the peel by pressing the hazelnuts against each other like that, and you see the peel is removed easily. Then place the hazelnut in the ramequin without the peel and then keep it aside. In the meantime, just pour some water. Cover the stinging nettles with water completely. And then add some vinegar. Just flatten until all the stinging nettles are completely covered with water and vinegar. You can then place a garlic clove into a mortar and just crush roughly just to remove the peel. So yeah, so once you have left the stinging nettles in the water and vinegar, place them in the blender. Okay, a little bit more, up. Perfect, and then you're gonna add the garlic clove, some lemon juice, so half a lemon juice. You're gonna pour the olive oil, and then you're gonna pour the hazelnuts. Okay, now it's time to blend. Et voilà, it looks yummy already. Then add a little bit of salt to season and then mix nicely. And that's it, our pesto is ready and it looks so yummy. Do you know what I like about this pesto? Is the pieces of hazelnuts, which gonna give some crunchiness to the pesto, and the spicy taste coming from the nettle. So you won't have any rash on your tongue, but it will only give you the spiciness that you could get from the chili, even though there is no chili. So yeah, that's a pesto to be enjoyed during the stinging nettle season. Bon appétit! Mm.